Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to export from Blender into Sketchup. All right, so the secret's out. I've been cheating on Sketchup with Blender, and I have a lot of fun modeling in Blender because it opens a whole new world of things that are much more difficult to do. Like all these sprinkles would be really difficult to do in Sketchup. I think you may be able to use the plugin Scalp, and you could probably use Viz Pro, but it would extremely bog down Sketchup if you did do that. So I enjoy Blender for this kind of stuff. So I'm not hating on Sketchup, it's just a very different type of modeling. What we're going to do here today is export this scene into Sketchup from Blender. Now, I've set everything up so that it is a little bit easier. I've used some layers here, so if you need to move anything to a different layer, you just select it and hit M, and then I'll bring up this little toolbar here, and then you just click on one of these boxes. These boxes represent layers. And then to show the layers that you want, you just come down here, and you just shift-click on the layers that you want to see. So I just have these set up to export, or to see. Now, what you want to do here is you want to make a selection of the things that you want to export. So hit B, and then you can select the area or the things that you want to export. Now, what you can see, there's a bunch of little dots here. What I've done, let me deselect this. What I've done is I've actually come in and then applied my modifiers, the particle systems. So what I've done for these sprinkles, they don't show up unless you apply them. That's, I assume, for any sort of particle. So you just select it, and then you have to apply for each of these donuts, and then the plate is what I did. And then when you've done that and you've made your selection, so it'd be selection, just come to File, Export. And I've exported as 3DS. What's nice about exporting as 3DS is that it allows you to, it keeps all the groups separate. So it has like one larger group, and then all the things in your scene will be separate groups within that. I have had some problems with that though, because things come in at different scales. Like my donuts were right, but the plate was really small. And the donuts were like not in the position that they are in this scene. So it has its advantages. It seemed to be smoother and quicker. But what I've had some success with, if you're trying to just get the geometry, is STL. So if you click STL, what I have down here in the bottom left set up is I have selection only, and then I also have apply modifiers. Now, apply modifiers, this is a pretty small scene. Like I said before, it doesn't work on particles, so you have to actually go in and make those particles physical in your model. But apply modifiers will work for your solidify. It'll work for that. And then, so you want to make sure that's checked. It's going to increase your time that you import into Sketchup a whole lot. So just be aware of that. You may want to try it without modifiers first and see if you like what you get. And then try with modifiers. But just make sure you make a cup of coffee or tea so you can wait for it while it imports. I think this little scene took 7 or 8 minutes to import. Just be aware of that. And then batch mode, currently is off. If you have batch mode set to object, it'll export each object separately as a separate STL file, which could be really nice if you want to sort of like reassemble your scene in Sketchup. And it'll probably be quicker that way. I'm not going to do that for this because I wouldn't want the scene to look how it looks in Blender. But the disadvantage is that everything is going to be stuck together. So you just sort of have to weigh your options in that regard. Now, I've already imported this into Sketchup, but to import, you just go to File, Import. You want to make sure that your STL file is checked here. And then you just navigate to your file, select it. You can see how long this is taking. just to preview. This is the one with modifiers. This one will show me right away without the modifiers. But what didn't happen with this is that my solidify on the icing didn't come through at all. So, but when you're in here, you want to click options. And then with modifiers, I wouldn't recommend adding any more time. What's going to happen when you import is that everything's going to be a triangular face by default. So if you want to keep the quads that you have in Blender, you want to merge coplanar faces. That'll make sure that anything that is a quad or a rectangular face in Blender comes in as a rectangular face in SketchUp. Then you want to preserve your drawing origin. For Blender, you can not check this. You don't have to check this because Z is up. And then units, you want to select that as well. For whatever units you modeled in. For what I did, it was like crazy units, so it doesn't matter because I would want to rescale anyway. So then you just set that how you want it and then hit import. Now, this is imported, like I said, it took about 7 to 8 minutes to import this, and there's so many faces. So, and there's like some clipping, some things that are going on, or not clipping, this face just didn't come over. So there's cleanup that's going to happen, and that's going to pretty much happen with anything. You can try a bunch of different settings, just messing with stuff. 90% of the time, you're going to have to do some sort of cleanup. If you want to bring in the more things that you want to bring in, the more problems you're going to have. So just be aware of that. So it's like super, super slow in SketchUp to move around. I've actually turned off all of the edges and the profiles because I knew that it was gonna take a long time. When you set this up, make sure that you have shadows off, have a quick style. So if you have your default tray open, you just want to make sure that your style is set to something that has one of these little stopwatches in the corner, so it's a fast rendering style, because it's gonna bog down your computer. So if, just to show you what it looks like with edges on, there's a ton of geometry that is imported. You can see all these triangles that were quads in Blender are now tries, and there's just a bunch of geometry here. But, you know, like if I wanted to export to V-Ray to get a really nice V-Ray rendering or Lumion, or and I don't feel comfortable in Blender yet, or I want to export something to the 3D warehouse, this is a good way to do it. You can always come in, double click on this stuff, right click, and then smooth the faces out. You can use Artisan to smooth some of these things out. I just figured I'd let you know how to import so that you guys can know how to do that. And maybe some Blender people will come try SketchUp out. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.